In flight, it impresses, majestic as it sails through the skies, strong and steady. It's the largest flying bird in North America, capable of cruising 55 miles an hour and traveling 150 miles in a single day. Because California condors can cover such impressive distances, they're hard to keep track of. I head out to Kern County, California, to Bitter Creek National Wildlife Refuge to meet up with Jeffrey Grisdale and his team with the U.S. Fish and Wildlife Service, the federal agency leading the charge to save the species.
Ready?
Ready.
Today, the team is doing some hands-on work with the endangered birds. It's really exciting to be here today because it's very, very rare to see them in this kind of setting. They're very social, very amicable creatures. The birds are caught twice a year for a health check and to get some new high-tech hardware.
So two of the devices that we use for monitoring California condors are this solar-powered GPS unit and then this VHF transmitter.
So I'm gonna put this transmitter right up against where it's coming out of the bird's body.
Does it affect the way that they fly?
This thing is really tiny. It doesn't weigh very much. It doesn't really get in the way of their flying. This is called a Yagi antenna.
The gear used to pick up the frequencies is a bit old school. It pinpoints a specific bird out in the open. But it's the GPS that is the bird's lifeline to survival. And they're monitored here at the San Diego Zoo Institute for Conservation Research.
Okay, so welcome to our spatial ecology lab. This is where we process and analyze all of the data that we get from the condors that we're tracking in the wild.
The Institute monitors 30 condors that now call Baja California home.
So here we've got over 100,000 GPS location fixes. This is the reintroduction site, but we found that the birds are actually moving over to the eastern side because this side gets the sun first thing in the morning. So that desert heats up, creates those strong thermal winds that the birds like to soar around with. So that's something that we didn't see, that we didn't know about until we got the data from the GPS tag. So it's a fantastic example of how technology is really driving the field of ecology now.
In less than three decades, the progress made with the California condor has been fantastic. There are 429 condors alive today, with over half of them in the wild. Dr. Mike Wallace, condor program manager, has dedicated his career to saving the species. There were about 22 left when you started the program, right?
Yes. 22, and we're now up to well over 400 birds in the world.
In 30 years?
Yes.
How'd you do that?
Well, we manipulated the breeding rate of the birds.
California condors typically have a slow reproductive rate. Females lay one egg at a time, but if something happens to it, they'll produce another. It's called double clutching. Taking advantage of Mother Nature's plan, eggs are carefully confiscated. The chicks are then hatched and cared for by humans with as little interaction as possible. When the chicks get old enough, they get released into the wild. This is why after so much time and effort, losing a bird is a huge setback, especially losing a bird to lead poisoning, a leading killer of condors.
The thing that's most disheartening is the lead poisoning, because again, it's man-caused. We're putting them into extinction.
As part of nature's cleaning crew, California condors eat dead animals. They often feast on game killed by hunters using lead bullets. And when they accidentally eat a bullet fragment, that lead poison gets into their systems.
Good idea.
Today, there are a number of releases. But number 513 isn't one of the lucky ones. He needs medical treatment because of lead poisoning. One last California condor release of the day, and the privilege was mine.
A little bit and start to slowly stand up, and then we're gonna shift the bird so that it's gonna come up.
That was kind of terrifying. I'm shaking, but it was really exciting. It was kind of fun to see her fly off. What do you see for the future of the California condor?
There's been millions of dollars put in this program since the beginning.
Would you argue that it's worth it?
Yeah, I would argue that it's worth it. You have to draw the line somewhere. We're not going to accept that letting animals go extinct is okay.
only on Al Jazeera America.
A team of scientists are taking their inspiration from nature.
Technology, it's a vital part of who we are.
They had some dynamic fire behavior.
And what we do.
Transcranial direct stimulation. Don't try this at home.
TechKnow's team of experts show you how the miracles of science.
This is my selfie. What can you tell me about my future?
Can affect and surprise us.
Sharks like affection.
Catch new episodes of TechKnow on Al Jazeera America. Check your local listings or visit aljazeera.com.